You have to understand the true Islam has a very revolutionary message. The true Islam sees itself, I'm talking about modern Islam, not this idiotic, savage, brutal, barbaric, medieval, Wahhabi, Salafist version of Islam that they're introducing into the world. By the way, one way to kill an ideology, let's say you have a revolutionary ideology that provides solution, that's moderate, that's innovative, that's modern. One way to destroy that ideology is to create a parallel ideology that is savage, that is brutal, that is murderous. This way, when you have a parallel ideology, and they abuse the same terminology as the actual correct ideology, one way to kill that correct ideology is to create a parallel ideology and for it to be so brutal, so out of control, that even people within the Islamic world would be turned off. Some people think that Christianity was somewhat destroyed that way in the 20th century, but by the two world wars that the financiers, the international bankers, that the Rothschilds created in order for people to be so desensitized and to be so outraged. You have to understand, Hitler, even Hitler, introduced himself as a savior, as a Christian savior in some sense. World War I, Austro-Hungarian Empire. The Empire of Kaiser Wilhelm. A lot of these empires had a very religious Christian overtone to them. So the European masses of these in the Western Europe, they were so outraged that their faith in their religion of 1,000 years or 1,500 years was diminished. They're doing the same thing in the Islamic world. In other words, they're trying to create such havoc, such destruction, such absolute brutal savagery that even Muslims themselves would turn away from their religion and basically become whatever the West wants them to become. As far as the Muslim community here in the United States, there are a lot of public relation campaigns here to introduce the peaceful side of Islam to people here. You have to understand, the United States is a very multi-ethnic, multi-cultural country, and you don't have a you don't have a concentration of Muslims in a certain area. It's spread widely, across the country. So, as the good Muslims are spreading the peaceful message of Islam to their neighbors, to their communities, people are buying that Islamophobic rhetoric less and less, or at least the people that are buying it are either have an agenda, an anti-Islamic agenda, or they're just basic, pure, ignorant type of people.